Druga Kosa Pita Maeternum. Amen. Ego gentium absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrorum, tribo et nobis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Amen. Deus tu conversus in de papis nos, et plebs tua legitar in te. Ostende nobis Domine misericordiam tuum, et salvo parum tuum da nobis. Domine exaudo rox unem meam, et clamor mea salve digna. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spiritu tuo, orendus. Cantate Domino, canticum novum, alleluia. Quia mirabilia fecit Dominus, alleluia. Ante conspectum gentium, revelabit justitiam suam, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Salvabit sibi dextera eius, et oraculum sanctum eius. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritus Sancto. Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Cantate Dominum, canticum novum, alleluia. Quia mirabilia fecit Dominus, alleluia. Ante conspectum gentium revelabit justitiam suam, alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison, Christe eleison, Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax hominibus bone voluntatis. Laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te. Gratias agimus tibi propter maniam gloriam tuam. Domine Deus rex celestis, Deus pater omnipotens. Domine Filii unigenite Iesu Christi. Domine Deus agnus Dei filius patris, qui coles peccata mundi miserere nobis, qui coles peccata mundi suscepe deprecationem nostrum, qui sedis ad dextra patris miserere nobis, coniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus Jesu Christus, cum sanctus spiritus gloria Dei patris. Amen. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Deus qui fidelium mentes unius effecis voluntatis, da populis tuis, in amore quod precepis, et desiderare quod promittis, ut inter mundanas veritatis, ibi nostra fixa sunt sint corda, ubi vera sunt gaudia, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, Ecum vivum reman in etate spiriti sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Lectio epistolae beati Iacobi apostoli. Carissimi, omne datum optimum et omne donum perfectum, de sursum est discendent a pater, luminem apud quem non est transmutatio, nec vicissitudinis abumbratio, voluntarii enem genuit nos verbo, veritatis cum sinus initium aliquid creaturae eius. Scitis fratres mei delectissimi, sit autem omnes homo devox ad omnientum, tardus autem ad loquendum, et tardus ad ira, ira enum iri, justitiam Dei non operatur. Propter quod agientis omnes injustitiam et abundantiam delitiae. In mansuetudine suscipite istum, verbum quod potes salvare animas vestras. Alleluia, Alleluia. Dextera Domini fecit virtutem, dextera Domini exaltatit me, Alleluia. Christus resurgent et mortuis iam non moritur, mors filii opera non dominabitur, Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spiritu. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem. In illo tempore, dixit Iesus discipulis suis, vado ad eum, qui visit me, et nemo ex vobis interrogat me. Quo vadis? Sed quia ego cubis sum vobis Christitia implevit cor vestro? Sed ego veritatem dico vobis, ex idit vobis ut ego vadem, si enem non abiero, paraclitus non meet ad vos, si autem abiero, mitam eum ad vos. Et cum venere filii, arduet mundum de peccato et de justitia et de judico. De peccato quidem quia non crederunt in me, de justitia vero, quia ad patrem vado et eam non vehebat me, de judico autem quia princeps, quius mundi iam judicatus est, ad hunc multa habeo vobis dicere, sed non potestis portare mundum, cum autem venerit ili Spiritus veritatis docebit vos omnes veritatem. Non enem loquetur ad semticos, semtipsos, sed quecumque audiet loquetur, et que ventra sunt annunciati vobis. Ili me clarificavi quia de meo accepit et annunciavi vobis.
The Epistle of St. James. Beloved, every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no change, nor shadow of alteration. Of his own will he be, he has begotten us by the word of truth, that we might be, as it were, the first fruits of his creatures. You know this, my beloved brethren, but let every man be swift to hear, but slow to speak and slow to wrath. For the wrath of man does not work the justice of God. Therefore, casting aside all uncleanness and abundance of malice, with meekness receive the ingrafted word which is able to save your soul. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time, Jesus said to his disciples, I am going to him who sent me, and no one of you asks me, where art thou going? But because I have spoken to you these things, sadness has filled your heart. But I speak the truth to you. It is expedient for you that I depart. For if I do not go, the Advocate will not come to you. But if I go, I will send him to you. And when he has come, he He will convict the world of sin and of justice and of judgment of sin, because they do not believe in me, of justice, because I go to the Father and you will see me no more, and of judgment, because the prince of this world has already been judged. Many things yet I have to say to you, but you cannot bear them now. But when he, the Spirit of truth, has come, he will teach you all the truth, for he will not speak on his own authority, but whatever he will hear, he will speak, and the things that are to come he will declare to you. He will glorify me, because he will receive of what is mine and declare it to you. Thus far the words of the Holy Gospel. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. It is truly meet and just, right, and for our salvation to praise thee, O Lord. We hear this in the preface of the Mass, talking about praising God. And we are to do this in all the things we do in life. We are meant to praise God with our whole life. Not simply at Mass on Sunday, but every day of our lives. This is one of the ways that we love God and remain in his love, something that we hear a lot about in the Mass and in the scripture readings. For our reflection and meditation today, I would like to share with you an excerpt from a homily given by St. Augustine on this very topic of giving thanks to God and praising him. In particular, he's speaking about the meditations on the Easter Alleluia, and how the joy of Easter differs from the joy of Lent, and how this mirrors our very earthly life. It's a very lengthy quote. St. Augustine says, "Our thoughts in the present life should turn on the praise of God, because it is in praising God that we shall rejoice forever in the life to come. And no one can be ready for the next life unless he trains himself for it now. So we praise God during our earthly life, and at the same time, we make our petitions with yearning. We have been promised something we do not yet possess, and because the promise was made by one who keeps his word, we trust him and are glad. But insofar as possession is delayed, we can only long and yearn for it. It is good for us to persevere in longing until we receive what was promised and yearning is over, then praise alone will remain. Because there are these two periods of time, the one that now is beset with trials and troubles in this life, and the other yet to come, the life of everlasting serenity and joy. We are given two liturgical seasons, one before Easter and the other after. The season before Easter signifies the troubles in which we live here and now, while the time after Easter, which we are celebrating at present, signifies the happiness that will be ours in the future. What we commemorate before Easter is what we experience in this life. What we celebrate after Easter, or from Easter forward, points to something we do not yet possess. This is why we keep the first season with fasting and prayer. But now the fast is over. Now we devote the present season to praise. Such is the meaning of the Alleluia we sing. Both these periods are represented and demonstrated for us in Christ, our head. The Lord's Passion depicts for us our present life of trial, shows how we must suffer and be afflicted and finally die. The Lord's resurrection and glorification shows us the life that will be given to us in the future. Now, therefore, brethren, we urge you to praise God, that this, what we are all telling each other when we say, Alleluia. You say to your neighbor, praise the Lord, and he says the same to you. We are all urging one another to praise the Lord, and all thereby doing what each of us urges the other to do. But see that your praise comes from your whole being. In other words, see that you praise God not with your lips and voices alone, but with your minds, your lives, and all your actions. This is, of course, personified in the person of Our Lady. Her whole life, my life magnifies the Lord and praises the Lord, our whole being. We are praising God now, assembled here as we are in church. But when we go our various ways again, it seems as if we cease to praise God. But provided we do not cease to live a good life, we shall always be praising God. You cease to praise God only when you swerve from justice and from what is pleasing to God. If you never turn aside from the good life, your tongue may be silent, but all your actions will cry aloud, and God will perceive your intentions. For as our ears hear each other's voices, so do God's ears hear our thoughts. So what a beautiful thing for us to meditate on about how everything and anything that we do in life as Christians is meant to be praising God. And it's something sometimes I think that Catholics, we're not comfortable with talking in that type of language. But our whole being, from the moment of our baptism to the moment of our death, is meant to be praising the Lord. So we ask the Holy Spirit to come and be with us and to encourage and strengthen our spirit and our faith, that we may go out and praise God and spread the good news of the gospel. God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Credo in unum Deum, patrem omnipotentem, facturam caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Jesum Christum filium Dei unigenitum. Et ex Patre natum ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo verum, genitum non factum consubstantialem Patrem, per omnia facta sunt. Proper nos homines, et proper nostrum salutem discendite caelis, et incarnatus est de Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus etiam pro nobis sub putio volatum, passus et self opus est, et resurrexit tertia die secundum scripturas, et ascended in caelum, sedit ad dexteram patris, et in cherubim puris est cum gloria, Judicare vivus et mortuos, cuius rene non erat fines, et Spiritum Sanctum, Dominum et Vivificantem, qui ex Patre filioque procede, qui cum Patre et Filio sino adorato, et cum glorificato, qui locutus est per profetas, et unum sanctum catholicum, et apostolicum ecclesia, confitebor unum baptisma in remissionem peccatorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vita venturi seculi. Amen. causa di tentazione, se liberanos a male. Thank you. procedures in interest of Peckham Mayan to compensate their votes on our before any man name. Dominate on some leaders in interest of Peckham Mayan to compensate their votes on our before any man name. Dominate on some leaders in interest of Peckham Mayan to compensate their votes on our before any man name. Cum venerit paraclitus spiritus veritatis, filii argue mundum et peccato et de justitia et de judico. Alleluia, alleluia. Dominus vobiscum et cum spiritus tuo. Oremus. Adesto nobis Domine Deus noster, ut per neque fideliter sumpsimus et purgemur et vitipis et interpericulis omnibus eruamur, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivum reinat in aeternis pati Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum et cum spiritu tuo. Ite missa est, Deo gratias. Benedica Bosom Nipotens Deus, Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum et cum spiritu tuo, initium sancti evangelii secundum Johannem, gloria tibi Domini. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio apud Deum, omnia per ipsum facta sunt. Et sine ipso factum est nihil, quod factum est. In ipso vita erat lux homina, et lux in tenebres luce, et tenebrae eam non comprehenderunt. Quod homo visus ad Deo, quod non erat humanus. Hic vanitatem testimonium, ut testimonium redivere de lumine. Ut omnes credere per illo, non erat ille lux. Sed ut testimonium redivere de lumine, erat lux vera quae illuminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundo. In mundo erat et mundus per ipsum factus est, et mundus eam non condovit. Propria venitet suae quam non receperunt, quod potatum receperunt Deum, dedit Deus potestatem filius Dei fiat. His qui credunt in nomine Deus, qui non ex sanguinibus, neque ex non pati carnis, neque ex non pati spiri, sed ex Deo nate sunt. Et verbum caro factum est, habitabit in nobis. Et vidimus gloriam Deus, gloriam quasi unigenitia patri, plena gratia et veritatis. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we set up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us. And after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O most holy Mother of God. Let us pray, O God, our refuge and our strength, look down in favor upon thy people who cry to thee. And through the intercession of the glorious and immaculate Virgin Mary, Mother of God, of blessed Joseph, her spouse, of thy blessed apostles Peter and Paul and all the saints, do thou mercifully and graciously hear the prayers which we pour forth for the conversion of sinners, for the freedom and exaltation of Holy Mother Church, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God renew him, we humbly pray. And who thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus, Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. Now with prayer in times of a pandemic, heal not with us, Lord, according to our sins. Take not vengeance on us because of our misdeeds. Help us, O God, our deliverer. For thy name's sake, O Lord, free us. Remember not, O Lord, our sins of old. Hasten to help us with thy compassion, for we have become exceedingly poor. Saint Sebastian,